Assalamu alaikum. I am your host Mehboob Ahmed. In this video, I will tell you about the Constitution of Pakistan 1973 and its amendments. My main focus in this video is amendment. In this video, inshallah, I will tell you about the amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan 1973. First of all, I want to request you to subscribe my channel and tap the press icon button. Now I will tell you about the Constitution of Pakistan. Constitution of Pakistan 1973, which became into existence by the Zulfikar Ali Bhutto in 1973. It came into force on 14 August 1973. This is the third Constitution of the Pakistan. Constitution is a piece of paper in which a state, a country run. Basically, this is the definition of the Constitution. Now I will tell you about the amendment in the Constitution of the Pakistan. First amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan is 1974. First 1974 is that redefine the boundaries of Pakistan and remove the reference to East Pakistan. And second amendment in 1974 declared the status of Ahmadis as a non-Muslim and a minority. Third amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan in 1975, that is the preventive detention. The limit of the preventive detention has been increased. Preventive detention means a person who involved in the activities in which that are against the Pakistan and put into a certain place, that is called the preventive detention. In third amendment, the time period of preventive detention has been increased. Fourth amendment in 1975. In this amendment, additional seats were created by the minorities and the court deprived of the power to grant a bail to any person, detain any preventive detention. Fifth amendment, which came into 1976, that is the widened the scope of High Court. Sixth amendment in 1976, it provides that the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court and the Chief Justice of High Court increased the retirement limits. That is the amendment is five. And we can say that it provides the Chief Justice of Pakistan, Supreme Court of Pakistan, Chief Justice of the High Court may obtain his office until he has completed his term. Seventh amendment in 1977, it provides enable the Prime Minister to obtain a vote of confidence to the people of Pakistan through a referendum. This is the seventh amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan. Eighth amendment in 1985, that is the, in this amendment change government form from parliamentary system to semi-presidential system, in which the power of the president has increased. That is the eighth amendment. Ninth amendment in 1985, that is the, it provides that the injection of Islam shall be the supreme law. It passed in the Senate but could not be passed in the National Assembly, and this amendment is abolished in the 29th March 1988. And after this, the 10th amendment, that is the came into being in 1987. That is the working time in a year of National Assembly and Senate were curtailed from 160 to 113. And the amendment is 11, which came into existence 1989, restored the women's seats in the National Assembly. Yeah, we can say that revisions of the seats in the National Assembly. This is the 11th amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan. And 12th amendment came into being in 1991. That is establishment of the special court for the criminal crime. And the 13th amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan came into being in 1997 in the era of Mian Nawaz Sharif. That is the power of the president to dissolve the assembly and dismissing the prime minister was ending. This is the 13th amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan. 14th amendment, which came into being in 1997 in the era of the Nawaz Sharif. If the parliament member defects, he can lose its seat in the National Assembly. And now the 15th amendment came into being 1988. Thus, Holy Quran and the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet shall be the supreme law. But it passed in Senate, but could not be passed in the National Assembly. And the 16th amendment of in the Constitution of Pakistan, that is the which came into being in 1999. That is the to extend the quota system for more 20 years. That is the 16th amendment. And the 17th amendment is that in which came into being in 2003. The power of the president has increased. The power of the president to dissolve the assembly and dismissing the prime minister came into being according to the article 58(2)(b), in which discuss about the president within a dissolution within a 40 day to refer the matter to the Supreme Court, and then the Supreme Court will decide the decisions within the 30 days. And that then 18th amendment came into being in the era of the President Zardari and came into being 19 April 2010. This is a very important amendment in the Constitution of Pakistan. This amendment gave the provincial autonomy, and this amendment is very important in the Constitution of Pakistan and the future of the Pakistan. But our federation could not bear this, and in this amendment the power of the president to dissolve the National Assembly, yet dismissing the prime minister, has ended. In this amendment, the enhancement of the power of the high treasons article 6 has increased according to this amendment. A lot of things we discussed in this amendment, such as new fundamental rights, three new fundamental rights, rights of information, rights of education, and fair trial. This is three main new fundamental rights which came into a being, and balance of power between the provinces and the federation came into being. That is came through the amendment, 18th amendment. So that we can say that this amendment is very important for the future and the Pakistan nation masses. And after that, the 19th amendment, which came into being 2011. In this amendment, the appointment of superior court judges discuss in this amendment, additions of senior most judges of judicial commission of the Pakistan. And now we can discuss the 20th amendment, which came into being 2012. This discuss it provide the formation of the caretaker government with consensus. This is the 20th amendment. Now we can discuss the 21st amendment, which came into being 2015. This is the 21st amendment, which came into being 2015, which means in this era, that is the era of the Mian Nawaz Sharif, to extend the jurisdiction of the military court. This amendment is 21 amendment. 22 amendment came into being in 2016, in which it made changes in criteria in appointment of the chief election commission and the member of the election commission. In this amendment, a bureaucrats and technocrats will also become a member of the chief election commission or Pakistan election commission, or it can become a election commission of Pakistan. And now we can move forward to 23 amendment. In 2017, which this describe, in this amendment we can say that the seats of minorities has been increased in the National Assembly. Almost 14 seats was increased in the National Assembly, and also in the Punjab, Sindh, Balochistan and KP Assembly will also increase the seats of the minorities. In Punjab 10 seats, in Sindh 12 seats, in KPK 4 seats, in Balochistan 4 seats. This is the 23 amendment which came into the 2017. And now we can discuss 24th amendment in 2017. It describe, it allow delimitation for the general election, those are 2018, when the government of Imran Khan came into a power. But we can discuss about the amendment. It allows delimitations the general election 2018 on the basis of the provincial result of the sixth population and housing census. It will reduce 9 seats from the main province Punjab and increase 5 seats from KPK and 3 seats Balochistan and 1 seat from the federal area. And now we can discuss about the 25th amendment, which came into being in 2018. In this amendment, the bill aimed at integrating the provincial pata means provincial administrative tribal areas with connected with the respective provisions, and fata are connected via integrating with the KPK. And the last amendment, that is the 26th amendment, which came the last year when Asad Kaiser was the speaker of the National Commission Assembly. Now is Asad Kaiser is present the speaker of the National Assembly, which came into being 13 May 2019, through the National Assembly. That's it means the increase of seats of the FATA, formal FATA, we can say that the formal FATA, from 6 to 12 in National Assembly and 16 to 24 in the Provincial Assembly. This was the amendments which came into the Constitution of Pakistan. The total amendment which came into the Constitution of Pakistan are 26 amendment, which I discussed in this video. Inshallah, I will come back with new video with new enthusiasms. Inshallah, Allah Hafiz.